You too. What's up? It's your boy 360 Jeezy, and today in this video, man, you guys, I haven't done a tutorial in a while. I haven't really spoken on 360 ways in a while, but today I got time, cuz today I got time. I'm gonna teach you guys how to better your connections, how to minimize your forks, and how to brush properly. Stay tuned. Okay, so first things first, what you wanna do before anything else, if you have your do-rag on, obviously, take it off. I'm just gonna assume that you guys knew that. You needed to take off your do-rag. I don't want to assume that you guys are slow, but this just has to be said. I just don't know why. I just have to say that. Take off your do-rag before you start brushing. But anyway, after you got your do-rag off, make sure you brush your hair to where everything is laid in place like you want it. Now, you don't have to go on a full-blown brush session, but make sure from the time you are sleeping to when you got up, you take the do-rag off and you brush everything in place. Because sometimes when you sleep, or sometimes you're laying around the house, you're just doing normal activities, your hair seems to shift in the do-rag. So first things first, do a slight brush session. Now that you got that out of the way, get your pomade, oil, whatever you use. Today in this video, I'm using some oil. I'm using the Africa's Best Ultimate Herbal Oil, all right? Now, I don't know if this product is all natural. These days, I'm really not too focused on natural products. I'm more focused on what works for me. So oils right now are working for my hair texture and, you know, what I'm doing. You gotta find that product that works for you. Now, some of you guys are gonna ask me, hey, Jeezy, yo, 360, what's good, man? Hey, I got a question for you. Yo, check this out, 360. I mean, I just need to know one question. I'll be right out of your hair. Just let me ask this question. And the question that I'm gonna get is, how do you apply your oil? And the answer is the same way you brush your hair, the same way you apply anything else. Just put it in your hands and rub it on your hair and you'll be good, man. You'll be good. Cause you should be knowing that you finna do a brush session afterwards anyway. So it's all gonna distribute it evenly across your head if you're doing your brush sessions right. And I'm here to show you today how to do it. And I'm gonna tell you guys what you need to do to get it done. So stay tuned. I don't know why I'm backing up like this. I really don't know why I'm really backing up like this, but hey, you know, I'm gonna keep going with it. I don't wanna make myself look stupid than I'm already looking. So you guys gotta, you know, I'm procrastinating on the thing. So to tell you flat out what's gonna better your connections, it's actually slow, precise brushing. Being consistent. Brushing the same way, in the same order, with the same brush all the time. Being consistent, stroke after stroke, same way. Don't switch up, all right? That's how you get well-connected waves. Now, the brushes that I like to use are these Torino Curve brushes. Curve gang, all right? It's just what I like to use. You know what I mean? You can use whatever you wanna use as long as you're consistent with it. I like to use the Curve. I'm gonna teach you guys how I brush my right side, my left side, my top side, my back side, my crown side, all right? Using this brush. So when I brush my right side, I make sure that the tip of this crown brush is always near my crown. I don't brush on the side, you know, close to my crown. I brush with the tip and I drag it all the way down. Some of you guys, you know what I mean? You don't know how to use the curve brushes, and this is the best way to use the curve brushes when you have a swirl. And I wanna say when you have a beehive too, because you know, your crown area is a small area and you don't need a lot of bristle, you know, a wide bristle in that area. You need a small point to get in that area and bring it down and make sure, you know, all the bristles are touching every part of your head as you slide that brush down. Same goes for the backside. I start with the crown first. I put the brush right by the crown, that tip, drag it all the way down. Make sure I use the full brush as I go down, but making sure at the same time that the point and the angle that I'm brushing is on point. If you feel what I mean, it's the on point. You see the point to the brush, and I'm using it on point. You know what I'm saying? I had that Lil Wayne metaphor right there, that point. You know what I'm saying? I point at the point, which in which case the point had the other point, and it was on point, and then I had to point at the, Okay. All right. So for the left side, I actually do not use the point as much, because I'm dragging the whole brush on my left side, you know, towards my eye. That's just how my pattern is. Each side, especially when you're getting a swirl, your sides are not gonna match up. You know what I mean? You're gonna brush your right side way different than you brush your left side. So keep that in mind when you're trying to get a swirl. They shouldn't match up, or else you're, you know, somewhat getting a beehive. As far as the top, I brush like you were to use a regular straight brush. I brush straight down, or even at a little slant, but mostly right now I'm trying to train my hair to, you know, not have such a harsh slant, which it doesn't right now, but you know, it has a baby slant and I really don't want it. So I'm trying to train my hair to go straight forward. And yeah, and that's just what I'm doing with the top. Now, as far as the crown goes, when I do my sessions on my crown, I basically use the tip of the brush and the tip of the brush only. I do not brush it like I'm brushing everything else, starting from the crown down. I just strictly focus on my crown and my crown alone. I use the tip of the brush and basically go around in that swirl pattern. As you guys see on the screen, I'm brushing and I'm just tapping, you know what I mean? That AG method. Y'all don't know who AG is. She always on ES talking about tap, 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 the Facebook group ES. She always talking about tap, 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 tap. That's basically what you gotta do, all right? Tap that thing. So to sum it all up, and to do a little small recap, when you're trying to get your connections right, make sure you be consistent with the brush that you're using. Slow down, don't go so fast, all right? Take your time. The connections come over time. It doesn't come overnight. You're not gonna get good connections. People be like, hey man, how do I get my waves connects? I've been brushing for like a week. Listen, this is years that we spend brushing our hair, trying to get our hair connected, trying to get our hair right. You know, woofing is key, you know, growing your hair out. So you guys can see my other videos about woofing, but it all plays a factor when it comes to getting good connections. This is not something that happens overnight. This is a lifestyle. This is something that we do on the daily. If you don't wake up and think about brushing your hair, please stop talking to me about connections. If you brush your teeth before you brush your hair, please stop talking to me about connections. If you leave the house without your brush, please stop talking to me about connections. If you come to my shop, Velocity Cuts, and you ain't got no dope waves, and you sit down in my chair with a do-rag on, please stop talking to me about connections. If you got an afro right now and you asking me how do I get waves, please get off this video about connections. If that 3-year-old 180 baby has better waves than you and you're watching this video right now, please, you're actually in the right place, all right? Because that kid is spinning, okay? Listen, tell me, you need to watch this and we watch this, okay? Double time, okay? Because that guy, that kid there, he was, I mean, come on. I mean, you got to understand that that guy was spinning. I mean, he's only 3 years old and he's out spinning. Half of you guys out there don't even have the waves that he have. I mean, come on. YouTube, and just like that, that is the video. We are done here. Okay? All right, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button. Make sure you guys follow me on Instagram and Snapchat. My Snapchat is Jeezy360 and my Instagram is 360Jeezy. But it's your boy 360Jeezy. And I'm out of here. Chit.